Cahill Smith, who is our guest artist. My name is Mark Gubler. I'm the coordinator for the campus, and Dr. Nancy Allred, who is the director of the camp. And just want to share my gratitude once again for Dr. Allred for not only founding the camp, but for her continued dedication in running the camp every year. Can we just give her a round of applause? Welcome to the stage.
First is what you just heard is Nikolai Medtner. I'm always curious about this. who has heard of this composer before? Great, this is good. A few Medtner fans. He's becoming a little bit more mainstream, which I'm happy for because I've been trying to encourage that. Medtner is one of those composers that kind of gets glossed over because he was writing music like this in the early 20th century. So he's born 1880 and died 1951, and writing more or less in the language of Brahms and Rachmaninoff. But because he wasn't writing new crazy things, he was not maybe as popular as some other composers for the time. Those two pieces are from books of pieces that he wrote called Forgotten Melodies. They were important in his life. He was like me teaching in college. I teach up at Utah State University. He was teaching at Moscow Conservatory. He was getting kind of overwhelmed with all of the duties and teaching that he had, and so he asked for a sabbatical, which I heard is a wonderful thing. And he took with him on his break a trunk of notebooks. He had saved a lot of his notes from ideas that came to him as a composer. He didn't have time to write pieces with them, so he would just always jot them down in a little notebook and leave them. And when he went on his sabbatical, what he noticed is that he had occasionally written the same tune or something really similar several times in a row. So he would have written it and then forgot it for a few years and then rewrote it again. So he decided to choose those as being the most important music materials and to use them in pieces, so he called it Forgotten Melodies. I wanted to play him tonight because he's also very close with the composer Sergei Rachmaninoff, who you're going to hear about 30 minutes of Rachmaninoff tonight. And this is, if you would have asked Rachmaninoff who's the greatest pianist alive, he would have said Medtner. And if you asked Medtner, he would have said unquestionably Rachmaninoff. So they both shared ideas with each other often, helped each other with ideas for composition, and actually Rachmaninoff helped him organize an American concert tour, which he refused, interestingly. So the last piece I wanted to play of his is actually his first published composition. It is from a book of pieces called Eight Mood Pictures. And it's a special piece to him, and I just wanted to share it with you because it's so odd. It has a subtitle on it with a poem by Lermontov, which says, an angel was flying through a sky of midnight and singing a quiet song. And it was Medtner's belief that composition wasn't creation, but maybe recreation of something that already existed. So he thought he was just trying to find the music that already existed and sort of capture heaven's song, which is what happens in the poem. So the poem tells about a person who's kind of scooped up in the arms of angels, taken up to heaven, and shown what it sounds like, the music of heaven, and he's taken back down to earth, and he struggles his whole life to try to write it down. That's what the poem is about. For all of you music students out here, I wanted to share with you a little about the score. For a 16-year-old, it's amazingly complicated that he wrote this rhythm. So, and the rack, you'll have a melody shared between the thumbs, like a duet. And you'll hear that they don't fall together. They're sometimes separate. The rhythm of the right hand is this.
Thank you.
decided now that I would go back and learn them because I think they're just beautiful. So the first one is Andante cantabile in D major. It tries to do with the piano what Chopin always tried to do, which is to make it sing. You'll hear a single melody that begins in the middle of the piano, and it's trying to thread that one line all the way from the first note of the piece through the end, and has one very unexpected harmonic climax in the middle. The second one is Maestoso in B flat major. It's a piece that I always wanted to try to learn because the chords are too big for my hands, so I'm trying to make do with it. I hope you enjoy these two prelates.
Thank you.
Are we ready to go?
Thank you. moved down here about a year ago, a little over a year ago. We love it. We wish we would have moved down here sooner. Tonight I'm going to play an original composition I did. It's titled Triumphant, and my daughter wanted me to let everyone know I orchestrated the entire score. I wrote out the score, and I have such a respect for studio musicians. When I went into the studio, they sat down, they sight read what I had written. After about a minute, they said, "We're good to go, let's record it." And they did an amazing job. So I'm going to play with the minus track. I do want you to pay attention to, we do have an electric guitar and acoustic guitars and drums. My friend, Michael Gibbons, added an amazing guitar part. And my only direction, I said, I want it to sound like Top Gun. This was before Top Gun Maverick. I wrote this back in 2008. But listen for his phenomenal guitar part. And I'm going to play Triumphant.
Thank you.
the Midas track when Barack Obama was the president, and it was really inspired by the Olympics. We love the Olympic spirit, but after watching the 2002 Olympics here in Salt Lake, and then the 2008 Olympics, I composed this, and it was something I just felt inspired to do. So, I hope you enjoy.
Masha tonight? Okay, I heard some yes. That was not very enthusiastic. This is Rachmaninoff's birth year. He was born in 1973, so this is 150 years, and that's why we're playing all this music tonight. I was curious if we could get two more of the faculty up here to play one piece of Rachmaninoff. We can't let them get out of here without playing it. Nancy's still here, and I heard that Aubrey's backstage. Could you guys welcome them to the stage?
Thank you.
We have one more camp concert. It's the student concert, end of camp concert, tomorrow, right here, 4:30, in the camp. All the students have been preparing an ensemble together, like the ones you heard last night, or tonight, sorry. They're playing all together. They put it all together just this week, and it's really amazing what they're doing. So come out for that, invite your friends, invite your family, and find out who wins the Camp House Cup, too. Drive home safe. See you tomorrow. Woo!